Good morning, students. So today again we are going to discuss about direct and indirect speech. The last topic is exclamations and wishes. So today we will discuss about exclamations and wishes, how these type of sentences are solved and changed into indirect speech. See the examples there. First example, he said, what a beautiful place. He said, what a beautiful place. So this is a simple sentence. So here we will write, he explained. He explained that we have to change this sentence into assertive as well as into indirect speech. So what a beautiful place. So this means, what a beautiful place this is. So he explained that it was, we will change it into past tense. It was a beautiful. It was a beautiful place. So we will change it into assertive as well as into indirect speech. Following all the rules of direct and indirect, we will change it into indirect speech and make it as an assertive. What a beautiful place it is. Okay, what a beautiful place it is understood. So we have changed that sentence into assertive. In assertive, subject will be there first, then auxiliary verb. So it is a beautiful place, that sentence should be, but we have to follow direct and indirect rules. So is will change into was. Now next sentence. She said, alas, I am under. Okay, she said, alas, I am under. Alas refers to the sorrow. So here she exclaimed with sorrow. Whenever you will see alas word, that means it is for sorrow. Okay, so she exclaimed. She exclaimed with sorrow. With sorrow that I am under. I means the person who is sick. That is, she was under. Present tense will change into past tense. So she exclaimed with sorrow that she was undone. Next sentence. They said, hooray, hooray, we have won the match. Okay. Now this hooray word is, it is, that is exclaimed with joy. It expresses happiness and joy. So here you have to write it. They exclaim. So we will continue here. They exclaimed with joy. With joy that, here we will use that. We will change into they. We will change into they, that they had won the match. They had won the match. Okay, present perfect has changed into, here in the question it is in present perfect tense. So it has changed into past perfect tense. So we have to follow all the rules of direct, indirect, and as well as we are changing this sentence into assertive form. Next example. He said to me, he said to me, bravo. Bravo. This word we have seen many times. Bravo. You have done well. So this is bravo, you have done well. So now listen here, whenever there is bravo, we can use two words. Okay, that is applauded, applauded or congratulated. Okay, applauded or congratulated. See the spelling properly. So he said to me, bravo, you have done well. So instead of exclaim, we will use it here. He congratulated. Me, here what you mean by congratulated? Okay, congratulated means saying that. What he told congratulated means saying that you have done well. You means to whom it is said, that is I. And it is in the present perfect, so it will change into past perfect. I done well. So these types of the words, they change. So here we have seen, if it is a simple sentence, then you will write it only exclaim and change it into assertive as well as indirect form. Then next one, when a last word is there, he or she exclaimed with sorrow. Whenever you will see a last word, that is for the sorrow. Then whenever you will see hooray word there, that is exclaimed with joy or happiness. Then he said to me, bravo. So this bravo word, that is for applauded or congratulated. See the spelling properly and then write it, whichever word is familiar to you. Okay, that you will write it. So he congratulated me saying that I had done well. Now next sentence. Yes, next we will see it. Example, fifth example. He said, oh, I need a glass of water. Oh, only O word is there. So this O means that is he cried out for a glass of water, or he cried out saying that he needed a glass of water. So here you can write it, he cried out. O means cried out. He cried out urgently in need. So that is a O. He cried out for a glass of water. Or you can write this, he cried out. Second sentence you can write that down. He cried out that I need. So I will change into he. He needed. Simple present tense will change into simple past tense. He needed a glass of water. He needed a glass of water. So both these answers, you can write it this also and this also. Okay, both the answers you can write it. He cried out for a glass of water and he cried out that he needed a glass of water. Okay, next sentence we will see. He said goodbye my countrymen. He said goodbye my countrymen. So here it is he said farewell to my countrymen. Goodbye or farewell, that is one and the same things. So here the word is used. He bade goodbye to his countrymen. He bade goodbye to his countrymen. So for goodbye, for farewell, we use the word bade. Okay, so this bade word is there, B-A-D-E. That spelling you have to say it, check it out. Okay, now next sentence. Now these are the sentences for the exclamations. Now we are going to do the sentence for the wishes. wishes, we greet someone, we wish someone for the birthday, or that is for the celebrations. Sometimes good morning, good evening. So this is also the wish we put it. So that also we can do it here. He said goodbye, or he said good morning, good evening. So in this way, it is he said good morning. Okay. So this word, he said good morning. So here it will be wish. He wished. No one is there. So he wished good morning. Okay. He wished good morning. Now he said to me happy birthday. Suppose it is. He said to me happy birthday. So that is he wished me happy birthday. Happy birthday also we are wishing. So he said to me. He said to me, happy birthday. We will not use the short forms, okay? In English language, we are not going to use short form as you write it in your mobile. So don't use the short forms. So he wished me happy birthday. So that is also wishing. Okay, the salutations that comes in the wish. Okay, next sentence we will see it. He said, may God help you. May God help you in your exams. Okay. Whenever we wish a good luck for the exam, at that time that is we wish. So he wished that. May God. So it will change into God might. He wished that God might help me in my exams. Okay, we also wish someone good luck, best of luck, may God help you in your exam. So that is he wished, that is why he is wishing. Okay, but suppose it is 10th sentence. He said, may God save the king. Okay, yeah, may God save the country. So that is at that time. We are not saying it to particular person. So at that time it is not a wish. It is prayer. So it is told only to God. So he prayed that God might save the king. Okay, God might. Here it will be prayed. So what is the difference between these two sentences? In both the sentences, you are saying that may God. But here it is told to someone, may God help you in your exams. It is told to someone. And here he said, may God save the king. He is not telling to anyone. This sentence means he is saying to himself, he is praying to God that may God save the king. So at that time, it will be he prayed that God might save the king. Now, next sentence, we will see it. Again, the two sentences are there. Yes, we are going to do the next two last sentences here. Listen here. The 11th sentence. He said, let us play cricket. Okay? He said, let us play cricket. Now, let us. Whenever there is a such type of question, we add a question that shall be. Let us means we shall play cricket. Okay. So here it is suggested to suggested to or proposed to. Proposed to. Two word is used here. So suggested to and proposed to. Here only we use two word. Okay. Suggested to or proposed to. Whichever is easy and spelling okay for you, that you can write it. So he said, let us play cricket. Whenever there is let us. Okay. So he suggested us that we should play cricket. Let us means shall we play cricket. Okay, here he is giving suggestion. Let us means that is said, let us do something. So that is a suggestion. So he suggested to will be there. Okay, here we have write to us. To is compulsory here. So he suggested to us that we should. Let us means shall we. Shall we play cricket? So that is a suggestion. We shall play cricket. So we should. It will change into we should. Means that is shall we play cricket? So we should. Okay, then suppose the next sentence is he said, let me have some tea. Okay, he said, let me have some tea. So me is there. Here it is not a suggestion. Here the word is me. Here you will see us. So there is suggested to or proposed to. But here me is word there. So here you will not use it. Here suggestion. So here it is, he wished, that is his desire to have tea. He wished that he might, let me have some tea. So that is he might have, he might have some tea. Okay. So have you seen the difference between these two sentences? As we have seen here, may God help you. When it is told to someone at that time, it is wished. But when it is told to himself, oneself only, may God serve the king, ye bhagwan usse bachao, ehi bhagwan usse bachao. So that is a prayer we are doing to God. We are telling these to God. Okay, so that is he prayed that God might save the king. Here, when it is let us, at that time we have to use suggested to or proposed to. Only in this section we are using the words to here. Otherwise, instead of said to, we have used told or asked, or sometimes we haven't used that, if or whether we have used. But here in the exclamational form, we have used that, and also in the assertive sentence, we have used that. Only in the imperative and interrogative sentence, we haven't used that. Okay? So here in this two sentences, have we formed the difference? He suggested to us that we should. Let us means shall we. Because whenever we add a question tag for let us play cricket, so question tag is shall we. Okay, so that means shall we. Shall we will change into we should. Shall we change into should. And here it is let me. Means that is may I have something. So that is he might have. So let me means may I have something. So it will change into he might have something. So this is the difference between these two sentences. Here we have completed the topic, reported speech. Okay, we have completed exclamation sentences, we have done it. So now our reported speech topic that is completed. Okay, reported speech, or we can say it as direct and indirect speech. So these topic we have completed, reported speech or direct or indirect speech. So now yesterday we have made the revision of these sentences, this type of sentences. So today we have done exclamation sentences. So if it is a simple sentence, how beautiful it looks. So it looked very beautiful. Okay, you will change it into assertive as well as you will change it into following the rules of direct and indirect speech. Okay, if a last word is there, then she exclaimed with sorrow, yeah, he exclaimed with sorrow. And if instead of alas, if hooray word is there, then that is exclaimed with joy. Then we have seen there, if bravo word is there, then he applauded or congratulated. Applauded means tarif karna. Okay, so that is he applauded or congratulated me saying that I had done well. We have to follow all the rules of direct and indirect speech. The words will also change. and following the rules we will make it assertive as well as change it into indirect speech. That we have done it. And only O word is there. He said, "Oh, I need a help." So he cried out for the help, or he cried out that he needed a help. Both these sentences you can write it. Okay. Next we have done their wishes. Good morning, good afternoon. These are all the wishes. Birthday we are wishing. Congratulations. That is also a wish. Okay. So that you can write it. He wished me happy birthday. He wished me. Yeah, he wished. Good morning. In this way, you can write it. Then we have seen, may God help you. If it is told to someone, then it is the wish. But if we are saying, may God save the king, we are praying to God, we are saying to God, then that is a prayer. Then let us and let me, we have seen the difference. Let us means that is the suggestion, suggested to or proposed to. And let me means it is wish, his own desire. So he wished that he might. Let me means that is a may I. And let us means shall we. So very simple of these sentences we have done it. So we have completed now direct and indirect speech. Now next onwards we will start with the revision again for the unit test. Yes, till then, goodbye everyone. Have a good time, nice time, have a proper diet. Keep yourself healthy, fit and fine. Bye everyone.